Welcome to second class of probability here. Now we discussed already in the previous class review of set theory. We explained already union, intersection, everything. Now I am going to explain basic probability. But I can't give a definition of probability directly without knowing basic concept, some definition. Without knowing the supporting definitions, you are not understanding the probability. The very first step is random experiment. If you want to open any textbook, they given the depending on the random probability, the first definition is random experiment. Okay. Yeah. What is a random experiment? I am not going to give a definition here. I am going to take one simple example. Now I have to take one coin and tossing a coin once. Now, when doing the tossing a coin, I get ready and then I have to do the toss a coin. What before tossing a coin, where get ready, no? That is called random experiment. The random experiment means the outcome of the random experiment which cannot be known before happen is called a random experiment. Means what we are doing, that experiment, tossing a coin, throwing a die, we are get ready to do the tossing a coin, get ready to do the throwing a die, that is called random experiment. What before doing the random experiment, you know what are the outcomes. For example, tossing a coin. Before tossing a coin, you know what are the outcomes. What are the outcomes? Either we will get a head or tail. Total number of outcomes of the random experiment is called sample space. Suppose you throwing a die. So suppose you throwing a die once. What are the outcomes you are expecting? Getting a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The total number of outcomes for the throwing a die once is nothing but sample space. Yeah, random experiment is what are the experiment we are going to do the get ready, tossing a coin. We have to get ready for to do the tossing a coin. Get ready to throwing a die once. These are the nothing but random experiment. But before doing the random experiment, it is definitely possible to assess, to identify what are the total number of outcomes for the doing that experiment. That is called sample space. Suppose you toss a coin once. Before tossing a coin, it is possible to judge what are the outcomes you are expecting, head and tail. That what is total is nothing but sample space. Before throwing a die, definitely we are expecting either we get a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is nothing but sample space. What's the definition of sample space? Total number of outcomes of the random experiment is nothing but sample space. Now, this is a thing of random experiment. What we are doing, that coin, tossing a coin, throwing a die. So, tossing a coin is also, these are the nothing but experiment. This experiment is also called trial. The next is event. Suppose you toss a coin once. What are the outcomes? Suppose you toss a coin once. What are the outcomes you are expecting? Head and tail. Yeah. So, the getting a different number of outcomes are nothing but event. Getting a head is a one event, getting a tail is a another event. These two are nothing but events. Means, so the number of different outcomes of the random experiment is nothing but what actually? Events. Either maybe a simple event or maybe a composite event. Event is different number outcomes of the random experiment is nothing but event. Under the event, there are two types. One is a simple, another one is composite. Simple and composite. Yeah. For example, here I am going to take, suppose throwing a dice once. What are the outcomes throwing a dice for once? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, the example of simple event is, suppose throwing a die, getting a number 1. Getting a number 1, what's a possibility? Only one possibility, 1. See, what are the events we get? We are expecting only once. Once you do the any random experiment, we get that event only once. That is an example of simple event. Suppose throwing a dice, getting an odd numbers. What are the odd numbers? 1, 3 and 5 are the odd numbers. have more than one. Suppose we get a number 1, we are telling odd number. Suppose throwing a die, we getting a number 3, we are treated as odd number. Suppose throwing a die, we getting a number 5, is treated as odd number. Getting an odd number having more than one possibility. That is an example of composite events. Simple event means we are expecting one type of event in the overall random experiment only once. Then have more than one option means that is nothing but composite. Therefore, getting an odd number is an example of composite event. Getting an odd number is nothing but simple event. Okay. The next is we are moving to the exhaustive cases. If you want to define a probability, exhaustive cases and favorable cases are very, very important. Yeah. Now move to the next definition, exhaustive cases. Exhaustive cases is a definition, is a very simple. Now suppose you throwing a die. Now, before throwing a die, you know what are the sample space. What are the sample space? I mean 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These number in the sample space is called nothing but sample points. Total number of outcomes of the random experiment is nothing but exhaustive case. Or total number of sample points of the sample space is nothing but exhaustive case. For example, throwing a die. Getting what are the possibility expecting before throwing a die is 6. These 6 are nothing but sample space. How many sample points you have? 6. The total number of sample points is 6, and then R, total number of outcomes of the random experiment is nothing but exhaustive case. Therefore, throwing a die, what is the total number of sample points is 6, R. Total number of outcomes of the random experiment also 6. This is called exhaustive case. Before doing this experiment, what are the total number of outcomes are expecting? That is nothing but exhaustive case, or total number of sample points is nothing but exhaustive case. The next is favorable. The favorable means the word itself is given rise the meaning of the favorable cases. Now I'm going to take different example first favorable case, then easy to understand further. Now I'm going to offer the students for 10 different books. I'm going to give in front of one of the student. What are the books you want to choose from out of 10 different books? He may choose one book, two books, three books, until 10 books. He can't select 11. It's not possible because I'm giving how many books I'm going to offer to select 10. Therefore, he is going to select one. Is telling why you selected one. See, my favorite is only this book now. Somebody they are going to select 3 books. Is telling that these 3 books are my favorite book. These are the values are nothing but favorable cases. Suppose I am going to offer 10 different books to one of the student. He is not selecting any book. He is telling that out of these 10 books, none of the books is not favorite. My favorite book. I don't want. He is not selecting any book. He may be selecting maximum how many books. He is telling all 10 books are my favorite book. Favorable number of cases. What's a favorable number of cases? Depends upon what? Outcomes of the random experiment. What is my outcomes of the random experiment? 10. How many books are I offering to the different books for the student? 10 books. Therefore, 10 books is my exhaustive cases. Out of 10 books, he is going to select 0, he is going to select 1, he is going to select 2 books, he is going to select 3, or maybe at most he is selecting how many? 10. These are the nothing but favorable cases. Favorable cases at most equal to the corresponding x has two cases of the random experiment. It's not xc. See, suppose you selected 11 books, is there any meaning? Because I am asked how many books? 10 books. We can't expect an 11th book. Therefore, favorable cases depends, at most equal to x has two cases. It's not exceed. X has two cases. This is nothing but favorable cases. What are the books you are selecting? From 10 books, that is nothing but your favorable cases. The another one thing is added, 0. It's not selecting any book. It's telling that is none of the book is not favorite. Therefore, that's also possibility. This is a meaning for favorable cases. Now, based on this, I'm going to write simple definition of probability. What is the definition of probability? Probability of the particular student is selecting out of 10 different books is nothing but favorable cases to the particular event, to the particular student. Event means what? Student divided by x has two cases. That gives us probability. Yeah, suppose one of the student is selected 2 books, what's a favorable number of books is selected, the particular student is 2 divided by x has 2 cases 10. This gives us the particular student probability to selection of 2 books out of 10 different books. What's a general formula? Favorable number of cases. Yeah, I'm going to write the general formula for probability is nothing but favorable number of cases to the particular event, whatever may be, particular event divided by x has 2 cases. That gives us probability. Just to give an example, one student is selected 2 books. Out of only 10, therefore 2 by 10 is the probability. Therefore, keep in mind, he may be selected 10. Yeah, he is not, say, I am giving same, this is 2 by 10. In the same example, what's the probability of, is not selecting any one of the book. What is the probability? 0 by 10. What is the probability? 0. At most, he selected how many? 10 books. Because how many books are offered? Only 10 books, 10 divided by 10. What is 10 divided by 10? 1. Therefore, observe, what's the minimum probability here? 0. What's the maximum probability is 1. Keep in mind, if you want to write the probability for any event based on any random experiment, minimum is 0, maximum is 1. It's not exceed this limit. Because just now given, out of 10 different textbooks, he may be selected none, he may be selected 1, he may be selected 2, he may be selected at most 10. It's not exceed 10. Therefore, 10 by 10 is 1. Is not selecting any one of the book means 0 by 10. It's not comes behind for this. Therefore, keep in mind, if you want to write the probability of any event, it must be in that right. Minimum is 0, maximum is 1. Therefore, suppose I'm going to take probability of any particular event, say A, it must be like PPM greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to 1. If you want to open any textbook, he is going to write this condition. Why? Because from this example is clear, because I am offered how many textbook, 10 textbook, out of 10 books, how many is favorable cases to select 0, at most maximum is 10. Therefore, if you want to take any particular event, what's the probability of the particular event is minimum is 0, maximum is 1. It's not exceed this range. Here is my particular event. Capital P denotes probability of the particular event. Now, the next is, complement. Complement means you already know that in the set A, this is my Venn diagram, universal set, A is a set. Okay. How to define a complement? A complement is nothing but 1 minus, U minus A. Okay. Like that, I want to write what is the probability of A complement. A complement is nothing, but favor is subtract. See, exhaustive case, no? What is my exhaustive case? 10. 10 minus exhaustive cases minus favorable cases to the particular event A. Yeah, you have to subtract A particular event divided by, keep in mind, exhaustive cases. I'm writing correlated to your set theory. See, that's why I have to recall the set theory in my first class. What, how to write the complement? Universal set minus the set, like that. How to write the probability definition in a complement? Complement means not in A. Means this A is favorable cases to A comes from what? Exhaustive case. Exhaustive case is my universal set. Exhaustive case minus favorable cases to the particular event A divided by exhaustive case. Split exhaustive case is cancelled. 1 minus favorable cases to the particular event, favorable cases to particular event A divided by exhaustive case is nothing but probability of A. Therefore, what is, how to find out probability of A complement is nothing but 1 minus probability of A. This 1 is a maximum probability. Why? Because exhaustive case, universal set divided by universal set gives 1. Therefore, if you want, suppose you have to know the probability of the particular event, how to find the corresponding complement of the probability of that event is nothing but that is subtract from. How to subtract from universal set? What's the probability of universal set is nothing but in favorable number of cases, also exhaustive case, what about exhaustive case, also exhaustive case, therefore is 1. Therefore, keep in mind, universal set is nothing but my probability value is 1. Therefore, suppose you know the probability of A particular event is happening, how to find out not happening means complement is not happening is nothing but 1 minus of happening is given like probability of not happening. Therefore, probability of happening plus not happening is nothing but 1. Keep in mind, you can't exceed more than 1. You can't expect a negative value. Probability of any particular event, you can't expect a negative. You are doing most of the problem mistake. Keep in mind, minimum value 0, maximum is 1. Sum of happening and non-happening, the probability must be equal to 1. I think everyone is clear how to find out not happening. Okay. Next, this is also very, very important. What are written about happening and not happening of the event must be equal to 1. 1 is nothing but probability of our universal set. Therefore, now is clear. Set theory to probability. Next, I move to what actually mutually exclusive events. See, mutually exclusive events, I'll give one simple example, tossing a coin. Suppose you toss a coin once. So suppose you toss a coin once, what are the outcomes you are expecting? Head and tail. Yeah, suppose you toss a coin once, you get head. You can't expect in the same toss tail. Suppose in the toss a coin once, you get tail. You can't expect in the same toss head. Therefore, getting head and tail, suppose you toss a coin once, are mutually exclusive. Means, out of different events, you are expecting at a time one event at a time. Events are nothing but mutually exclusive. Getting a head and tail, suppose you toss in a coin, are nothing but mutually exclusive events. Means you can't expect in more than one event simultaneously. Such type of events are nothing but mutually exclusive. Suppose you toss a coin, what are, either you get head or you get a tail, you can't expect in the same toss both. I told already in beginning my class, we are not considered tossing a coin standing vertically. Either turn up head or turn up tail. Now, the another way of know that mutually exclusive events, you can't expect, once you do any experiment, you can't expect in simultaneously more than one event. Such type of events are nothing but mutually exclusive. Therefore, tossing a coin once, getting head and tail are mutually exclusive. Next is equally likely. Yeah, just now explain what's the definition of probability. Suppose you toss a coin once. Yeah. Either we get a head or table. What is a sample space having? Head and tail is nothing but my sample space. Okay. What's the probability of getting a head? Favorable number of cases to getting a head is 1, because you are tossing a coin once, divided by n has 2 cases. Similarly, probability of getting a tail is nothing but favorable cases 1 divided by 2. Now observe carefully, both the probability must be same. Such type of events are called mutually exclusive. The another simple example I am going to share with the students, I am going to give one of a student one apple. Before I am going to hand over the apple, I am going to inform you, please share it to your friend, one of friend. There are two students are sitting here. I am going to hand over one apple to one of a student. You share it equally. What he is going to do? Both are going to take half of apple. Suppose three students are sitting. I am going to give one apple. Before going to give apple, I am going to insist to share equally. Therefore, what they are going to do, how they are going to share? They are going to take apple 1/3 part, 1/3 part each one. Suppose four students are sitting here. I am going to give one apple to share it equally. How they are going to share? 1/4, 1/4. Means, one probability, what's the maximum probability is 1. Is sharing equally. Both the way of know that equally likely, the another way to know that whenever having all the different events out, whenever having each of the outcomes of the events having the same probabilities, then we say that the corresponding events are equally likely. Therefore, probability of head and tail are same probabilities. They only are expecting two outcomes of tossing a coin once. Therefore, getting a head and tail, both are mutually exclusive events and also equally likely events. And also throwing a die once. What are the outcomes you are expecting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Getting a probability of getting a number 1 is nothing but 1/6. Same thing for number 2, number 3 like that, and also number 6. Therefore, getting a number 1 to 6 are mutually exclusive. Suppose throwing a die once, getting a number 1 to 6 are mutually exclusive events and also equally likely events. Equally likely events means whenever all the events probability having the same probabilities, then we say that equally likely. Whenever I have to do any experiment, you can't expecting one at a time more than events simultaneously. Such type of events are mutually exclusive. Next, I move to the independent events. I think it's clear for equally likely. Yeah, equally likely we discuss events. Yeah, next is independent. This is most of the students are they have a doubt for this. They have a confused with mutually exclusive. Yeah. Now independent. This is independent is a very important concept. Okay. Independent events. Yeah. Independent means, I'm going to give one simple example for the student. Yeah. Two students. Yeah. I'm going to give one problem to two students. Keep in mind, both the students are sitting so far. They are not sitting together. They are sitting maximum far from the place. A is sitting here, B is sitting here. Both are not using mobile. They are not. They can't do the communication also because they do very far from both the students sitting so far. You can't do anything. You can't do. They are not using voice. What about cell phone also? In that situation, yeah, they have one problem. A and B. Now I'll give one problem. Both. Both are salt. What they did? Both are salt. See, both are sitting very far. Means both are salt independently. What's the word I use? Both are salt independently. Even though both are salt independently, they must be have at least one common. Suppose they salt correctly. Both the students are salt correctly. What's a common thing is answer. Answer is common. At least one must be having a common. They solved independently. Suppose they solved correctly, at least one is common. What's the one is answer? They more than one, they may be having a common. Maybe few states may be a common. Both are maybe using same method. These are the things are possibility. Therefore, keep in mind, one problem are given two students, both are sit separately, both are students are solved independently. Even though they solved independently, they must be have some common. Suppose both are solved correctly, the answer must be same. Unique answer. They more than that, they may be having a common. What is more than that? They may be using same method. They may be using same few steps also like that. The way of convince the students is independent event means you are expecting more than one event simultaneously. Even though they know more than one events occur simultaneously, their probability finding that they must be having some common. We can't say that they don't have a common. This is a difference between independent events and mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive means you can't expect more than one event simultaneously. When you are talking about independence, we are expecting more than one event simultaneously. That's why I have given this example. This example is not given in any textbook. Yeah, even though they solve independently, they must be having common. Suppose they solve correctly, the answer is one must be common answer. Therefore, whenever talking about independent events, they must be having some common things in the both the independent events. This is a difference between mutually exclusive and independent. But in my textbook, they give you take in one hand one pack of cards, you take in another hand one coin, you do both the events simultaneously, you drop some cards and toss a coin. Suppose you toss a coin, both the things are done simultaneously, both the event. Toss a coin, you get a hit, you are dropping at a time, you have dropped 10 cards. How many cards you drop is not depending upon what we get tossing a coin. Both are independent, they're telling. But while solving a problem, you are telling whenever they having independent events, they must be having a common. If you are tossing a coin and dropping a card, there is no common. That's why I have taken this example. When you are talking about independence, they must be having common. Solve both are correctly, at least one is common. What is the common is answer. Therefore, keep in mind, therefore independent means they occur more than one event simultaneously, they may be having a common. But mutually exclusive means you can't expecting at a time more than one event simultaneously. Now these are the definitions. They must be important, basic definitions are very, very important while solving a problem, basic probability problems. What are the things I discuss here? First I discuss what's the definition of probability. What's the definition? Before I'm going to take definition of probability, I discuss first very definition is nothing but random experiment. Random experiment means before doing the trial or experiment, get ready, the position is called random experiment. Throwing a dice, tossing a coin, get ready, that is called random experiment. Before doing the random experiment, it definitely is possible to know what are the outcomes. The total number of random experiment is nothing but my exhaustive case. Under the now, what is the definition of event? Suppose you toss a coin, getting a different type of events are nothing but events. Under the events, there are two types. One is a simple event, another one is composite event. Simple event is the thing that once you do any experiment, we are expecting that similar type of outcome only once, that is called simple, otherwise is composite. Suppose throwing a dice, getting a number 1 is a simple event, getting the odd numbers is a composite event. Total number of outcomes of the random experiment are nothing but exhaustive case. I explain simultaneously sample space. Total number of outcomes arrived in the random experiment is nothing but sample space. Each values are nothing but sample points. If exhaustive case, another definition is total sample points is nothing but exhaustive case. Favorable case. So, see for example, you are offering the one of a student to pick any number, any books from out of 10 different textbook. He is going to pick 0 up to 10. Therefore, favorable number of cases to the selecting the book from the particular student is nothing but 0, 1, 2, 3, 10. It is not exceed 10, because what's exhaustive case is that favorable cases is within the exhaustive case. It's not exceed exhaustive case. Therefore, what's my probability definition? I written favorable cases to the particular event divided by exhaustive case. And also probability of what about particular event, you know that. How to find out probability of not happening? Complement. How to find out probability of not happening is nothing but to subtract favorable number of cases in a particular weekend from exhaustive case divided by exhaustive case. Simplify that, 1 minus probability of happening. Therefore, sum of probability of happening and not happening in this 1. Keep in mind, in any experiment, what is overall probability must be 1, is not exceed 1. Why? Because in the set theory, what's the which one having the maximum what about the elements? Universal set. Universal set divided by universal set is nothing but 1. Okay. The next, I explained mutually exclusive event. Suppose you toss a coin once. So in the once, either we get empty or empty, we can't expect in both. That is nothing but mutually exclusive. Whenever yet events can't expecting simultaneously more than one, such type of events are nothing but mutually exclusive. Next is equally likely event. Suppose, I told whenever I could write the probability of the different events having the same probability values, then we say that equally likely. A given one apple given to 2 students, 3 students, 4 students. That is nothing but equally likely. Yeah, what is entire probability is one is sharing equally to all the different events. That is nothing but equally likely events. Therefore, getting a head and tail for tossing a coin are mutually exclusive and also equally likely. Throwing a die, getting a number 1 to 6 are mutually exclusive and also equally likely. Because once we get number 1, we can't expect number 2, number 3 at a time. Next is independent event. Independent event is suppose having one problem. In that problem, suppose I'm going to give one problem to 2 students. I insist both the students as far from the places. They are not using cell phone. They are not communicate. Therefore, they solve independently. They solve at a time simultaneously independently. Even though they solve independently, they must be having, suppose they solve correctly, they must be having one common thing. What is that answer? For this type of event is nothing but what is actually independent events. Means independent events means they are expecting more than one event simultaneously and also they must be having a common. Such type of events are nothing but independent events. Now before I'm going to move to the next step. Now I'm very considering what about repeated trials. Suppose you toss a coin once. What are the outcomes? Sample space having one H and T. Suppose you toss a coin twice. What are the sample space expecting? H comma H, yeah, H comma T. And then at a time you are expecting two outcomes, T comma H and then T comma T. How we get this? You just have to take Cartesian product with twice. We get 4 points. Okay. This is 2 points, this is 4 points. Yeah. 2 can be written as 2 power up and 4 can be written as 2 square. Yeah. See, we repeated same trial twice. Yeah, repeated once. See, whenever I want to know sample points without writing a sample space, then suppose you say repeated trials, first you find out the single trial. What's the outcomes of a single trial is nothing but this. How many times are repeated, that becomes power. Similarly, suppose you toss a coin 3 times. If you want to write the sample space, definitely we get 2Q. Whenever I have repeated same trial more than once, without writing a sample space, how can you know that how total number of sample points? First you take a first trial. What's the total outcomes of the first trial is nothing but our base. How many times I repeated it, right? 2 square, 2, 3 like that. Suppose you toss a coin 4 times, How many sample points are expecting in the sample space is 2 power 4. Writing in all the sample points is very tedious once you go repeated more than once. But in some problem, I don't want each every sample points. I want to know total number of sample points that use this concept to write. But this concept is only work for repeated trials. Like that, try a single dice once. What are the answers? How many sample outcomes of the sample space? 6. Suppose you throw a pair of dice. How many sample points are expected? 6 square. 3, 6 cube like that. Yeah, without writing sample points, how do you know how total number of sample points? Suppose you are doing repeated trials, you are repeating same trial more than once. Keep in mind, this is a very, very important. This works only for repeated trials. Yeah, I think it's very well clear. Without writing sample space, how do you know that total number of sample points? Suppose it's a repeated trials. Yeah, like that. This is only work for how to take a repeated trials total number of sample points. First, you count what's the total number of outcomes of a single trial. That's our base. How many times repeated, you write it a power. That gives total number of sample points in the corresponding repeated trials. Okay. Thank you very much for listening what I explained. I'll come and meet you in the next class. There I'm going to take basic problem, how to solve basic. Before I'm going to take basic problem, I'm going to discuss in the next class addition theorem and multiplication theorem and condition probability. These things are very, very important. After that, I'm going to take problems for how to solve these addition theorem and basic definition and multiplication theorem. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye. See you and take care.